Today we're going to do a tissue box makeover. Yay! So we're going to paint this. And because we're using the Fleur de Lis from Totally Dazzled, I made these fleurs from a mold that I got off Etsy. And I just used the quick casting resin. And we're going to use these. And we're going to put some Riba Rose rice paper on it, these beautiful butterflies. And then we're also going to put this from Riba Rose on the back side of it. I think it's really pretty. Yes, Karen, it was a rockin' auction. So first off, because I want to put these on, these are just quick casting resin molds. I'm going to put these on resin, but if you heat this up, it will kind of flex and bend a little bit. And I am going to go in with some stick fast and see if this works. You did. So see how pretty that looks? We just put that on there. Now I'm going to put one on the other side as well. Another thing I wanted to add on here was some Would You Bend. I have this Would You Bend molding. It's number 1449 and it's just here. And I was thinking about putting this up in the corner of the tissue box just for a little added depth and dimension. And as you can see, we just kind of decorated the top. I know it looks a little wonky right now. Our Fleur de Lis are holding up great with the stick fast. Okay, got a paintbrush. We are gonna do some white craft matte folk art paint. This is not sealed yet, so I want to be careful, but I want to add in our decoupage paper. So all I'm going to do right now is just kind of, I'm going to take some infuser from Posh Chalk, and I'm just going to put some on here, grab a brush, and I'm just going to lay that down on the one side without the fleur. We're going to take our butterfly print, and I really want to get the whole butterfly in there. So see how I did that? I just smoothed it on. Hope to God that it's straight. Buff out any little wrinkles or whatnots that you might get in there. And let that cure. See, here's what I'm afraid of. Okay, that's good though. So now I'm going to flip it over on the other side. We're going to do the exact same thing to the other side with the other butterfly. Because I want to take a sanding block and I want to sand off the sides, but I don't want to peel off my paint. So it's going to be a little tricky. And I'm just kind of going over it gently. This might work too. Dip it in some water and just water cut the rest of that out of there. Let's see if that works. Because I don't really want to sand too hard and have my paint chip because we haven't sealed the paint yet. So now what I want to do is I want to seal this paper down, okay? So we have that here. Isn't that pretty? I want to seal the paper down. So I'm going to take a little bit of my force field, or not my force field. This is the, this is from the infuser from Posh Chalk. You can find that on the Would You Bend link. And I'm just going to go over, and that's going to seal that paper down. All right, so we have that. That's just about, now we're gonna dark wax it. So I go in with a little bit of clear wax and then I take a little bit of dark wax. And I'm just gonna go in, I'm gonna start making sure I don't have any puddly pieces because you don't want that. And I'm just gonna go in, I think I want it to be a little bit darker. So I'm gonna go in and You just want to make sure you get in all those nooks and crannies, like so. Okay, so now we got the top all done. See how pretty? So see how it just kind of looks like old? I do want to take some gold rub and buff, and I'll show you what I want to do with that. So I'm going to take a little bit on my finger, and all I'm going to do is like here on the sides, and I'm just going to kind of run up so it just kind of, just adds a little bit of something. A long skinny brush like this. And I'm going to do the images first, and I'm just dipping into my, this is three parts triple thick, two parts Duraclear, and, or you can use one part Duraclear, and I'm just going over, and I'm going to dry it. See how that, it's got that gorgeous shine to it? See? Nice and shiny all the way around. And I just want to find which fleur works. And I'm going to drop it right on top of the fleur. Kind of like this. See? Kind of like, almost like shadowing the fleur-de-lis. So I think I'm going to use this one. I'm just going to cut off this little tab right there. Cut that right off. It's just a little, I just pop it off. And all I'm gonna do is use some B7000 and I'm gonna use a little bit of hot glue. So, and I'm gonna lay that right in the center. Line it up. Come on, Lord. But see how I just added that fleur in there? So I'm gonna grab the same one and I'm gonna put it on the other side. We could put, a pretty butterfly would be pretty, like right here, like we could double layers. This is where I can get really fancy. And let's do it. Let's take some butterflies from Totally Dazzled. See, so I'm talking about just like a small little butterfly, like right here on the butterfly. So see? And again, I'm just going to, right now, for snickles and kickles, I'm just going to use hot glue. Some little butterflies. I think I'm going to go in with this one right here. Just another little one right there. Ow, 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 that was hot! Little butterfly there. Love the fleur-de-lis. Little butterfly there. Now, I do want to add... I do want to add a little bit of bling up at the top. I'm going to grab my rhinestone picker pen, and I'm going to grab some Tolle, the B7000 glue, which is what you get in your Rhinestone Ultimate Rhinestone Applicator Kit. And what I'm going to do is just, so anyway, there it is, the fleur. We added a little bump butterfly on top of a butterfly. There's the other side. I did add the gold, and then the top. See that? It's got those little sparkles just here and there.
Totally Dazzled sells sparkling rhinestone wedding supplies. Check us out at totallydazzled.com. But before you do, click up here and download our free printable sparkle quotes. Or click down here and watch one of our other awesome tutorials.